Hello there, Marshall here from Limited Resources. We're jumping into another draft with you here on Channel Fireball. This one is Masters 25. So it just came out a couple of days ago, and we are in. What can we do here? Boros Charm. Elvish Piper's kind of sweet. A little fragile, but can be powerful. There's also just Murder and Swords to Plowshare. So if we want to go with a more conventional limited pick of just taking a really good removal spell, we can do that. And I think we should. So I'm going to take the best removal spell ever printed if I'm going to have the choice to do so. I'm going to take Plow. So we'll take Swords to Plowshares. And we'll see where it goes from here. Ooh, that's some sweet art on that one too. I'm actually recording this one from the hotel room in Phoenix. I'm down here to cover GP Phoenix, which of course is put on by ChannelFireballEvents.com. Ta-da! Little name drop. Let's see where this deck takes us. I did one draft of this format already, so I have a little bit of an idea. And we did a podcast about it, so I researched it pretty well. I know what's going on with the format in broad strokes, but I don't have any sense for the rankings yet about, you know, what's the very best versus the worst. So that's kind of what we're going to be trying to explore here. All right, we have to pick something kind of quickly here. I'm just going to go with Murder. Looks like the internet here is not super great, but hopefully it'll hold up. Just don't have a lot of time. I could take a Brine Elemental, but I'm just going to pick the Murder so that we make sure we get a pick. There we go. Freed from the Reel. That's another removal spell. What's in white and black? Dauntless Cathar. I like that card a lot. Ruthless Ripper I like as well. There's some good green cards here. Arbor Elf is nice. Elvish Aberration's okay too. It's kind of interesting. Freed from the Reel you can use on your creature to give it the ability to the Horseshoe Crab thing, or you can use it on theirs to lock it down for a mana per turn. I think I want to go with Ruthless Ripper or like White Mane Lion or something like that here, though. Yeah, let's go with Ruth. I like that card. Relentless Rats, Skeletonize. What is this? Side of the Snow Winter creature and his brother you may attach. Oh, just for free. That's kind of cool. Phyrexian Ghoul. We know that you can do some cool stuff with that. There's also some nice blue cards here. I like a Fathom Seer. I could move Heart into blue, or I could just take Cloud Shift. Best black card in the pack is probably Ghoul. Relentless Rants is just whatever. Could take a Griffin Protector. No, we'll go with Cloud Shift. Let's see if we can't put together a little bit of a value deck here. Isan's Shade. Oh man, I remember that card from back in the day. Promise of Brunei. Or Boon Ray. Tune away whenever when a creature you control dies, sacrifice it. If you do, you get 4. Wow, that's insane. Diabolic Edict, no. Dirge of Dread, no. Cutthroat, no. Another Protector, sure, whatever. I never actually played this. So my creature actually has to die. Yeah, let's try. That is a lot of things. Ooh, a Sift? Oh, man. Sift or Nyx Fleece Ram? A decision that I never thought I'd have to make. Sure. Ancient Craving, well, that's kind of like Sif. There's also a Disfigure, Lunark Mantle. Oh, my God. All right, whatever. If blue's going to be that open, I'm just going to take it. So which color would I rather play here? Oh, I'd rather play all three. All right, if I'd rather play all three, then let's take Prophetic Prism. Yeah. Death's Head Buzzard. Another Cloud Shift, or I could take a Dauntless Cathar. Let's just Cloud Shift it up. Let's just build the Cloud Shift deck. We'll probably just end up cutting these black cards and just moving into blue. We're probably not going to get a whole ton of blue in the second pack, but we'll get a lot of it in the third pack, and we'll pick up some decent stuff in between. Maybe we'll even wheel something, too. There was multiple good picks out of some of those. Here's Shoreline Ranger. I like that. Another Cloud Shift. We could have 3 Cloud Shifts and just take all the ETB creatures, or we could take one of these Land Cyclers are just kind of a solid common with a Dauntless Cathar. Yeah, whatever. There we go. We're all set. All we need are enter the battlefield cards and we're good to go. More morphs. Choking Tethers, Dauntless Cathar. We'll take the Cathar. I like this card. It's just solid. Nothing exciting, but it's solid. White, clearly the most open color. We're still getting picks, even multiple picks late in the pack that might make the cut in our deck. So we're going to keep that in mind. And then our second color will have to kind of present itself to us as we work our way through the packs. Could be anything. Oh, Fathom Seer came back. We will take that. So let's see. Morph. Return two islands to its turn. When Fathom Seer is turned face up, draw two cards. So we cannot use Cloud Shift to get the cards from Fathom Seer. But if we do end up in blue, we could just play it. Here's another one. That seems fine to me. And we just need more things that enter the battlefield and make us happy. Brainstorm. Also, some of the morphs that you can Cloud Shift just end up being kind of massive or whatever. Oh my god. We open Nicol Bolas Actual. Two, four, six, it's eight mana. The card seems pretty bad, actually. We could take Pacifism. That's kind of the boring pick. We could take Court Hussar. That's a really good one with Cloud Shift. It's basically what? Just draw a card. Look at the top three cards of your library. Put one of them in your hand and the rest in the bottom. So not only draw a card, but, you know, draw a good card. Angelic Page, fine. I think it's between Pacifism and Court Hussar. Let's take Court Hussar. We need Enter the Battlefield cards, so that definitely fulfills that requirement. Here we could take Thalia, which could be pretty annoying for our opponent. Is it annoying for us? Yeah, kind of. Counterspell or Pacifism are also options, or another Court Hussar. I think I'm going to take one of the not Court Hussar cards and hope to wheel it. It is really only good in blue-white, and we're in blue-white, so we have a much better chance to wheel it than you normally would. I'll go with Counterspell. I'm kind of a sucker for that card. Oh my god. Yes, we did it. Oh my god, there's a Man of War in this pack too. Oh my god, we got a Cloud Blazer, you guys. Hey, everybody. Oh my god, we overpicked three Cloud Shifts and then just got past the Cloud Blazer. That's basically perfection. Excludes, nice. What else is there? Fathom Seer again, a Loyal Sentry, Renewed Faith, or another thing. No, we'll go with Exclude. Wait, Vesuvian Shapeshifter? When Vu enters a battlefield or is turned face up, you may choose? Oh, yeah. That's sweet. So that means that Cloud Shift actually works with it. Oh my god, Fiend Hunter too. Oh, we're doing it now. What does this thing do again, though? It polymorphs? Yeah, we don't want that. We want this. Oh my god. Wait, another Manowar and Cloud Blazer pack? What is happening? Oh my god, a Merfolk Looter. We're so smart. Man, moving out of black has paid some serious dividends here. Perfect drafting. Perhaps a dash of luck in there for good measure, but oh my god, we are doing it. This is awesome. Coral Helm Guide. Target creature can't be blocked this turn. Arcane Denial, counter target spell. You draw a card, they draw two. Not super great. Counter your own spell. Could just take a Shoreline Ranger. It's a little boring. I think I'm going to take it, though. I want to make sure I hit my land drops. And it's also just a fine magic card, like just a good 3-4 flyer, you know, in the late part of the game can often be the biggest flyer and get in for a bunch of damage or block. Got a lot of card draw. We do need some places to put all that mana. But we're going to have a lot of flyers, and now we can Vesuvian Shapeshifter, copying Cloudblazer, or whatever. So, yeah, that's pretty nice. We did it, as predicted. Court Hussar comes back. So what are some things we want to find now? I suppose I should prioritize some of the removal. I've got the Swords of Plowshares, but beyond that, I took a counterspell and exclude, but I passed two pacifisms. So I guess we do have Fiend Hunter as well. But still, I want to make sure that I cover that base. Probably don't need Dauntless Cathar, but we'll see. Rainstorm generally not that great. Oh my god, yes. Oh, buddy. Here, you know what? You guys get your own cage over here. There, they hang out over there. So sick. When you force three cloud shifts, basically, and you get these type of cards back, you are just doing it. How many of you thought that was another Man of War? I did. I guess we take it. I could take a Prophetic Prism to enable splashes. Yeah, I think I will. I've already got two Fathom Seers. I don't think I'm playing all of them. White Mane Lion. Yes, that is on theme. Probably going to run a bunch of lands in this deck. We really just don't want to miss land drops at almost any point here. I like this guy. Mystic of the Hidden Way. He's very hidden. Wow. We have 25 playables right now. By the way, I don't think we want this anymore. We're on a much more streamlined plan at this point. All right, what do we have? Conflux. No, we can't really do that. Twisted Image. Sure. Disenchant Dragon. Dragon's Eye Savant. Well, there's literally one white card in this pack. Weird. And only three blue cards, though. They're all fine. Genju of the Falls is okay. What has become a 2/2 flyer? Oh, 3/2. That's probably fine. Twisted Image I could see taking. And I could also see taking Dragon's Eye Savant. So I'm actually going to take Twisted Image. It probably ends up in the sideboard, but when you bring it in, it could be really good. This is interesting. I think I'm actually just going to take Shadow Mage Infiltrator here. We've got two Prophetic Prism. I can cast it probably pretty easily. And it's quite strong. And if I don't play it, I'm fine on playable, so I don't have to worry. Geist of the Moors, Griffin Protector. I think it's bigger when other creatures enter. Coral Helm Guide. I guess I want this or this. I'm not really excited about either one. I'm going to take the Dragon's Eye Savants. This thing does block really well. And what do? I reveal a blue card? Yeah, I've got tons of blue cards to reveal. Show them the bad news, you know. And I get to look at a target opponent's hand, which is just a nice little bonus as well. Twisted Image tends to be the card that you can play in any deck if you really want to, but it ends up being not super great. It's a little free rolly though, because all you need is any creature to target with. You can draw a card. And if you get lucky and your opponent does play some, you know, 0/4 walls or whatever, you can just kill them. You can also combine it with combat to do things. Mystic of the Hidden Way, Path of Peace. Destroy target creature, its owner gains 4 life. I think I need that. I was going to take Curiosity because we do have some cheap creatures and ways to get stuff out of the way, but I'm going to take the removal spell. It's a little conservative, but I think we need to be a little conservative at this point. We already have enough power to win the game pretty easily. Here's another one. So this gives us unconditional removal. I like that. All right. Sideboard? Sure. Yeah, this deck looks sweet. Ooh, there's a Sift. Take that. Because we're not drawing enough cards somehow. When do I have to sack this? Just put the trigger up right away if you didn't spend white. So it still costs 3 mana. It's just that I have to put a white into it or else it goes away. Okay, that's a deal. What set is that from? Hmm. Ravnica block. Homelands. Yes, 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 yes. just a pile of them now. Sure. All right, let's see what we're actually looking at here. 28. That's a lot of playables. Could just cut that, this prisms and the black card. I mean, it's not like we need to draw more cards. We have infinite card draw on this deck. Nyx Fleece Ram, I think we could cut, but I kind of like it. It's just really annoying for any deck just trying to kill you with any speed whatsoever. Not really doing anything busted with Retraction Helix. I'm just going to take another Mystic. I feel like Mystic is a good win condition as well. I wonder if I still want the Shoreline Ranger. Oh, I'll take this Curiosity. Don't think I'm going to start it, though. I do like it. Do I have to do damage, right? Like actual real damage? Let's find out. Yeah. So I can't use it on the Savants. I mean, I can put it on there, but they just don't actually deal damage on their own. All right, so we still have some cuts to make. Wow, we've got a lot of value in this deck. A lot of value. I think I'm just going to cut the Fathom Seer. We can't really abuse it, and I don't think that I'm going to... I think I'm just going to want to keep all my mana around because I've got so many different things to do with it. Cloud Shift, Exclude, Sift. I could see cutting Sift. I mean, we do have two Core Hussars and two Cloud Blazers with three Cloud Shift. We already have quite a few cards dedicated to drawing more cards, but I do love Sift. Mystic of the Hidden Way. That can go. We'll just play one of them. Looter, I'm going to keep. I guess I could kill the Savants. Yeah. We can always shift our curve downwards. We can play two Dragon's Eye Savants if we want. I think the Nyx Fleece Ram is just better. So I'm going to go with that. Oh man, this deck is so sweet. K98. Yep, yeah, that's what I was thinking as well. And there she is. My masterpiece. Now we're going to see if what we can do with this thing. Maybe we'll even get a 3-0 out of it. If you want to pick up Masters 25 and Rivals of Ixalan and whatever you need, you can do it at Channel Fireball right now. We'll see you in round number one. Okay, round number one. And this does look like a keep to me. Kind of a must-kill Merfolk Looter on turn two. And we're going to hit all of our mana, no problem. Might even not need to cycle Shoreline Ranger. And we can Mana War if they happen to have a relic. Like if they go, you know, threat, kill your looter, that kind of thing, then we have answers. And the Sick of the Hidden Way is actually a reasonable draw too. But first things first, Merfolk Looter on two, and then we'll see where it goes from there. Myriad Landscape. And red mana, so Kindle's an opportunity here. Soulbright Flamekin, that's fine. Give everything trample all you want. So this is the hold the baby moment. Don't kill my looter. Don't do it. Leave my looter alone. These games are so much different if you get to untap with the Merfolk Looter versus if you don't. It's crazy. Hey, we did it. Ooh, opponent didn't even attack either. That's craziness. All right, let's loot. Let's see what we get. Plains, good. Get rid of it. And I think I'm just going to Mana War away the Lizard here. I could also play the Mystic of the Hidden Way face down, but I'm not going to. I'm just going to play Mana War. And that fully stabilizes our board and sets our opponent back significantly on tempo. And I'm really just looking to curve out from this point. Next turn, I'm depending on what we draw, but I'm just going to play the Mystic face down, then I'm going to play Cloudblazer, then I'm going to play Shoreline Ranger. At least that's my plan. What did you do? You myriad landscape. Okay. Just want to set up their mana, it looks like. Yes. All right, let's see what we get. White Mane Lion, that's fine. I'm just going to attack. And here, I think I'm actually just going to pass the turn rather than playing the Mystic, because I think what I'm actually going to do with this turn is cycle away Shoreline Ranger and just play White Mane Lion to pick up Mana War. And if my opponent decides to kill the looter, I'll save the looter with the White Mane Lion instead. They go Skeleton Eyes or something along those lines. Assume that they don't have a Kindle. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, I think I just take this rather than trading off the lion, because the lion actually can get in for damage. And I'm winning this race. I'm kind of winning on all metrics at the moment, but I'm going to put myself a little bit behind by returning my Mana War. Okay, get an island. Cast this thing. And it's just a parade of jellyfish. Okay, so there's land number 5. So this turn I think I'm just going to attack here and just play Cloudblazer. Because I get Cloudblazer online and I can start really going off. The one argument against it is I can loot. I'm going to loot either way, but I can loot to try to find a Cloud Shift for the next turn. But I think that's just being a little bit too conservative. Because the truth is if your opponent uses a removal spell to kill your Cloudblazer, you're usually pretty happy anyway. Goblin War Drums. Creatures you control have menace. It's kind of interesting. Fortunately for my opponent, they will no longer be controlling creatures shortly, and that's probably the best thing that we could see, to be honest, is pacifism. I have 2 Mana Wars in my hand and 3 Cloud Shifts in my deck. I think we're going to be able to beat that. All right, so let's loot. We can't block anyway, so just get it out of the way. Sure. Take 5. Then I'm probably just going to play 2 Mana Wars here. Oh my god. This is just stupid at this point. I'm going to deck myself. before I win this game. Well, let's play a Man of War. Bounce this guy. And then I'm tempted to just actually play the Mystic, but I don't know if that's what I should do or not. Yeah, I'm going to do it. If I ever feel like our life is even remotely being threatened, we can bounce a Cloud Blazer, replay the Cloud Blazer, play our other Cloud Blazer, probably find a Cloud Shift somewhere in that time frame. We may have a Nyx Fleece Ram going by then. All of a sudden, our life total doesn't look like it's under its threat nearly as much. That poor Thresher Lizard just getting bounced around. I wonder if I should bring in... This is an interesting question. Should I bring in Disenchant? There's Goblin War Drums, a card that we don't care about a ton. And there's Pacifism, another card that we don't really care about. Still, it's two targets. And there could be scenarios where we do care about those cards. Pacifism's unlikely, but the Goblin War Drums could be annoying. Like if our opponent just curves out and we're not really able to keep up, if we don't draw our Mana Wars or whatever, it could get us. Opponent should probably attack there, but chose not to. So we will loot. Don't need a land. I feel like I think I'm just going to go Manowar. Yeah, I think I'm just going to go Manowar, Thresher Lizard. Actually, maybe I'll just Manowar the Flamekin. Because it's what, three times, four times? I can't remember. Oops. No, that's not really what I meant to do. That's okay, though. Alright, this all works out the same way I wanted to anyway. Cause hey! Did not want that block to happen. It's really annoying. It's actually not that big of a deal, but that's still really annoying. I did not mean to pass through to the block stage. Untap target creature, it gets +2/+2 until end of turn and can block an additional creature this turn. Okay. Fiend Hunter. All right, well, unblockable guy down, which is really annoying, but because I was actually just going to pay before blocks, but I don't know if I F6'd or if it just didn't know that I might want to do that. But at any rate, it's really not that big of a deal. Still significantly ahead on board. See if opponent has Akroma's Vengeance. That could help them get back in it. I do have a solid game plan, though, with just replaying Cloud Blazer right afterwards. And if they don't have it, they're just in terrible shape. Just generally. Boros Charm. Menace Indestructible. Am I dead? What is happening? Armageddon? Wow. That was pretty sweet. I don't think it matters, but that was pretty darn sweet. We're just going to have to start looting into lands. We're also just significantly ahead on board, so it's kind of like fine either way. Yeah, it's probably just unlikely that we're going to get to enough lands. So, in with the team. Did not mean to attack with the Nyx Fleece Ram, but my opponent's forced to block one of my 2/2s, so it probably doesn't matter. That's a sweet block. What the hell? Oh, man. My Nyx Fleece Ram attack was genius, clearly. Oh, man. Boros Charm Armageddon me. That is mean. That is mean stuff. problem is I'm just way too ahead on board for that kind of play to really be awesome. Curious to see if I actually need to find any more lands. That's the interesting thing here. Like, can I just win with this board? If I attack with everything right now, they could go Thresher Lizard on Merfolk Looter, Soulbright on something and lose. So that doesn't work. So they have to go trade Thresher Lizard for, say, Manowar, trade Flamekin for Manowar, take three, go to one, have, at least as the board sits literally right now, no board. Browbeat. Any player may have Browbeat, deal 5 damage to him or her. If no one does, target player draws 3 cards. Do I should take 5 damage? Yes, I do. I just don't want to give my opponent any more cards, and I don't think that they can realistically race from this scenario. They can't even attack me this turn with anything. And I'm getting 1 life a turn back from the Nyx Fleece Ram anyway, so it's like not a bad spot. Okay, back to 12. All right, we hit a land. I'm just trying to decide. Yeah, so I think I am just going to jam, actually, especially since I hit a land. So this, 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 and this. This will put our opponent to 1 and wipe their board, so it'll leave us with 2 threats. Smart blocks, kill the good cards. Simian Spirit Guide? What the heck? Oh, they made their Thresher Lizard into a 4-4. And there's more? Oh my goodness sakes, they should have done that pre-combat though. They could have just blocked one of my guys. Or after attacks, I should say. Now they're going down to 1. Yeah, that's interesting, but so now they're going to have 3 blockers for 3 attackers. Okay, we might actually have a game on our hands here. In Merfolk Looter, we trust. Don't need much to go right here. Planes, Cloud Shift, Swords to Plowshares, another Man of War. Noble Templar. Okay. He still can't attack. Back up to 13. Let's find some lands. Yes, that's good. I'm going to loot. And a Man of War. More likely here. I'm trying to decide between these two to get rid of. I have no planes at all, so I guess Path of Peace is probably still closer than Fiend Hunter is. So I'm just going to play my land and pass here. I've got my Manowar, my Counterspell up, and then I have a potentially lethal Manowar if my opponent... Actually, that's not true. We know that the last card in their hand is the Soulbright Flamekin, so they do have that going for them. They can start hitting us with the Noble Templar, though. I can't really block it. Getting kind of interesting. But we've got a lot of turns. There we go. A plane. So if I cast Manowar, I just win, right? No, of course I don't. They cast that guy. So I need one more thing. So what I think I'm going to do is play the Court Hussar. And that way we can find an answer and then win next turn. All right. Maybe I should just take a land. I don't know. Probably... just Path of Peace, but feel like I'm pretty confident I can hit my land drop. by next turn. And my opponent does have to top deck here. Yeah, he's in there. I'm down to 8. Virtual 9 thanks to the RAM. What did you draw? Nothing. All right. I'll loot then. Another Court Hussar. Yeah, I'm just going to get rid of Sift. We're not doing that. There is a Cloud Shift. Let's see if we can find a land. Actually, 1, 2, 3, 4. I could just Man of War and attack with everything. That probably gets the job done. I think I'm going to wait one more turn. I'm just going to draw a card here. Don't want that. All right, so I'm just going to wait one more turn because if I do it this way, I can play Cloud Shift on my Cloud Blazer. And my opponent doesn't know about that. And I can also just leave up Counterspell. So if my opponent finds a way to just kill me out of nowhere, you know, there's that sorcery that does 7 damage or whatever, then I can counter it. And then I'll have a land. I can probably just play Man of War and just have tons of stuff. A Morph. I will counter the Morph. And that should be game. I'm just going to take this as well. And we found the victory. Value. Oh yeah. All right. So we got down to 8 cards in library. Funny. I think I want to bring in like Dauntless Cathar just to have a little more punch. I'm going to cut Sift. I think Sift is actually just unnecessary in the deck and I might just get rid of it. It's very powerful, but we should, like, if our deck does what it wants to do, then we're just drawing so many extra cards. And then I could bring in the disenchant, but I want to see something I really can't handle before I do. Boy, that Merfolk Looter went the distance, didn't it? MVP. Should we keep this? Yes. Yes, we should. It has Merfolk Looter. It has a counterspell. Actually, it has 2 counterspells, and it even has a pretty powerful morph. Real question is, do we play Merfolk Looter or counterspell on turn 2? Well, part of it's going to be determined by this. If they put out a threat, yeah, then we kind of need to get the loot going. If they don't do anything on turn 2, then it can be reasonable to wait and just counter their 3-drop. But that's not what's going to happen here. Ooh, that's a good one. So now I really just want to find actually white mana sooner than later. So I can count, just so I can cast this guy. Because Court Hussar actually just blocks just fine. So let's see if we can't find ourselves a plains. We do. What do I not want here? There's a lot of value to be had. There's some good counter spells. Maybe just a shapeshifter. I don't know. I can start shapeshifting pretty quickly here. Just feel like we have all of our bases covered. I guess I can just be a little greedy here and just ditch that. And we're going to be getting more cards. So I'm just going to count or cast a Court Hussar right now. And let's see if we I probably just want to find lands. Okay, I didn't find lands, but boy did I find some action. So Man of War or Plow. I'm just going to take Plow. We've got plenty of stuff to do with our mana, or with our hand, and we've got tons of action here. So I don't really feel that I need to go for even more. We've got Cloud Shift, but we have Cloud Blazer plus Vesuvian Shapeshifter. Like, we have stuff to do. At this point, though, what I really want to do is just get to untap here with Exclude and Counterspell available and Looter going and just kind of start to take over the game. I'm just not going to block this Perilous Mirror. I'll just lose my Looter. And one damage is worth that. All right, opponent's now missing land drops where we are not. So that's good. Just gonna attack. White Mane Lion. I could exclude this, but do I really care? What is it gonna do? Just block? That's fine. Go nuts. They throw the double block. I'll just order Thalia first and trade off my Court Hussar for Thalia. Obviously, I would do that. Okay, so I'm going to pass here and just leave up Exclude. And then I'm going to loot. And once again, just looking for lands. Because once we hit Cloud Blazer, it's just done. I mean, we're going to play Cloud Blazer, gain life, have an attacker. Then we're going to be able to Cloud Shift it. And then we're never missing a land drop. And Thalia doesn't matter anymore and all that. So that's kind of what we're going for here. Opponent's just going to use his turn to fix their mana and to ramp out a bit. With Myriad Landscape, that means no attacks. And interesting question on if I should use a removal spell here. I don't think I should, though. I do want that. Could also just wait. Yeah, so just going to be patient here. Man of War. I can't Man of War and Cloud Shift, though, because of stupid Thalia. I'll just wait again. Our opponent's going to get to untap with four and possibly five mana here, so this is probably a pretty good time to leave up our counters. Loyal Sentry, when it blocks a creature, destroy it. Okay. We're hoping to fly over, so we don't care about that. And here's a Perilous Mirror back again. That card actually is kind of annoying, so I'm going to go ahead and exclude it. We'll still have Counterspell for anything really nasty later. That is not included in really nasty. So yeah, now we get to loot one more time. We're just going to keep this Plains, though. And I'm just going to slam Cloud Blazer, I think. Sure. Let's get this party rolling by discarding a card. Pretty funny. All right. Now, what if they Armageddon us here? We're okay. That's mildly annoying. see what they do with it, though. I guess they just attack with White Mane and Flamekin. Oh boy, maybe I'm wrong. What? This is only when it blocks, right? The heck? Maybe they just have a trick or something? And they don't care because they don't think I'm going to be attacking them? Okay. That loyal sentry was a little too loyal, perhaps? Yeah, all right. Take it. Let's just do this and leave a counterspell. I got good answers for pretty much anything we really care about at this point. And we are looking to be in very good shape. I wonder if I should just start mana warring away cards like Thalia. Also, it could just be time to just use Swords to Plowshares on Thalia. She's definitely proven annoying. But the thing is that I think sometimes people conflate annoying with good. Simeon Spirit Guide just got exiled. This opponent is just all in. This looks like something to counter. What is this? Maybe just a 3-6? Yeah. Sure, you got a 3-6. It's another card I can just beat. I also can just bounce it. All right, let's bite the bullet here. Get rid of that. Let's loot. Sure, multiple mana wars seems good. Back up to 18. Path of Peace. Let's do that. I get to attack here. And I'm just going to pass. I don't think I'm going to leave Counterspell not available at any point, basically. Just don't want to get blown out by some random rare or, you know, if Armageddon ends up being really good or something like that. A morph. Yeah, I don't care about a morph. Might even just mana war it. Loot. Cortazar. No, I don't think we need that. Play a Cloud Blazer. And draw some cards. And now we're just totally in the driver's seat. Unless, of course, that morph is something just unbelievably good. But even if it is, we can mana war it. Counter it on the way back down. Should I block it? Probably should. Just block with this thing. This thing, oh, it has menace, right? I guess I have to double block then. All right, I'll double block then. I don't really care if one of these dies, if they want to spend a bunch of mana to transform this thing. I'm willing to give up on board, I mean, call it advantage, but the Cortisar is not doing much for me anyway. just to find out what this morph is or force the issue. We have a lot of luxury here, given that we still have a stacked hand and we're ahead on board. Plus we have that insurance policy with the counterspell sitting back there. And things are going to get very man-o-war-y here very soon. Looks like opponent just said, okay, sure. All right. Seems fine to me. All right. Gaining life, doing the stuff. Sure. Cloud Blazers in. Let's just see what's under there. I also just want to build out my board. So, Man of War beat down. What is this, a Skirt Commando maybe? Corona's Zealot, four and a morph for bunch. When it's turned face up, all damage will be dealt to it is dealt to target creature. Weird. They could have flipped it up and killed my Merfolk Looter. Seems strange. I think I would have done that. All right. Your move. Permanents you control get indestructible until end of turn. All right. Fine. I'm countering it. I want to get this game over with. And that does, in fact, end it. All right, so we win round number one. That's going to send us into round number two. We'll see you there. All right, round number two. Yeah, this seems fine. This is one of our not-so-strong draws because it doesn't have Looter in the opener, but it's still fine. We're on the play, so we get to slam Court Hussar, keep it around, and then curve into Cloud Blazer, or even have Path of Peace to kill a potential threat. So this is a fine hand. Merfolk Looter makes hands look much better, kind of no matter what. And we had it both times before. What nonsense have you brought? Ire Shaman. That is a little bit annoying. Definitely a little bit annoying. Also pretty aggressive just running it out. All right, what do we want? Mystic of the Hidden Way. Definitely don't want an island. Do I want a white main line? Probably just a white main line. Bonus deck looks pretty aggressive. They're just hard casting Ire Shaman, start getting in for damage. Whirling Outburst versus Court Hussar does work for us, though. And also taking white main line looks smart now. I'm just going to play, actually, I'm going to do it the other way, but I'm just going to play Man of War. Bounce one of these gobos, send it back, and get in. And this way, I can just curve right into Cloud Blazer next turn. I'm just going to cast it, most likely. This also lets me put blocks on the Ire Shaman, and holds back the goblins still. If my opponent does some type of aura shenanigans, I could also white main lion the mana war and then replay the mana war. Or just path of peace a creature. So I've got a lot of options. Ooh, blue. What do we have here? Chandra's Outrage. That is outrageous. But. Ooh, another Court Hussar. Yeah, it was just Cloud Blazer. Cloud Shift. That's pretty nice. I'm just going to sit back. I'm not going to block the Ire Shaman, but I'm going to just hold back the Goblins. It's a little conservative to do it that way because I can get in for 2 damage, but look at my hand. I mean, if this game goes long, I am just in total business here. Treasure Keeper, you say? No blocks there. Okay, so now what do I want to do? I can play 5 mana. Like, I could do Court Hussar, White Mane Lion, Cloud Shift. I could have all of that. I could just Cloud Shift the Cloud. Like, I could attack with it and then just Cloud Shift it. That seems pretty reasonable as well. It gets me the cards and the blocker. And I could still leave up White Mane Lion or cast Court Hussar. So I think what I'm going to do here is actually cast Court Hussar. And see what we hit. I get a little more information here. Path of Peace, another Cloud Shift. I already have a Path of Peace in my hand as well. All right, I'm just going to take another Cloud Shift then, I guess. So let's get in here. Just going to go for this now to guarantee that we get the life and the value. A lot of planes. And I'm just going to pass. Now I can leave up White Mane Lion or the other Cloud Shift, depending on what opponent does. Ooh, they're going to pay a 6 drop. Shoreline Ranger. Shore indeed. Assuming no attacks. Now they're going to send in this guy. Wow. Let's just play White Mane Lion, return Cloud Blazer. And then trade off the White Mane Lion for the Ire Shaman here. Just keep this train rolling. Kind of interesting. You know what I think I want to do? That. And then I can turn it into a Shoreline Ranger and just block and still keep up Counterspell or even Cloud Shift if I really want. So yeah, I'm just going to do that. And then that way, I probably won't block this. I'll just eat the Treasure Keeper if my opponent decides to attack. It's 1 in a blue, right? Yeah. So let's see what you're going to do. Going to attack with both. Okay. So do I want to leave up Cloud Shift or Counterspell? I think Counterspell. Get one of those. Go to blocks. I'm going to take the 3 in the air, but eating a Treasure Keeper is a pretty big game, and then I'll have a blocker for that Shoreline Ranger. Might even just use Path of Peace on it. Trumpet Blast. Well, does actually hit me for 5 here. You're still attacking. Oh, it's damage. Right, of course. Yeah, that is a miss. I forgot. Bummer. Ooh, this looks counterable. Yeah. Yeah, I'll counter that, and then I'm going to use Path of Peace on the flyer. I may turn this creature face down. It looks like opponent scooped. All right. So we valued them out. I'm into that. I think Dauntless Cathar wants to come in again for Sift. Again, I just don't need a Twisted Image. That didn't seem very good. Dragon's Eye Savants. Reasonable, but not great. I like the removal spells against this opponent for sure. Just want to be able to kill that stuff. Yeah. Just do that. Is this a keep? Probably. It's a little all in on Man of War to kind of slow down a potentially quick start, but Man of War is very good at doing that, and it does have the tools to win the game if we find a Plains. Oh yeah, that's pretty scary. Right, Counterspell is actually not the worst rip here because we can play it and counter our opponent's 3-drop and then still have Man of War available, so that's pretty good. Finding a playable 2-drop is actually decent there. Ooh, opponent skipped through their attack on accident. Ooh, interesting. All right, well, I still just play an island here, but finding a plains is a pretty big deal. Court Hussar looks particularly good in these spots as well. Yep. Frenzy Goblin is a problem. It means that I need to have more and more creatures. I'm going to counter pretty much whatever this is. Oh, I can't. All right. I'm just going to play the Man of War here. I'm just going to bounce the Frenzied Goblin. That lets me trade off potentially for the Jackal Pup, the Bad Dog. And then likely, well, actually we'll see what happens here. I will trade if given the opportunity, though I could see making the argument for not trading and just trying to leave up Counterspell and Cloud Shift on the Man of War, but it doesn't seem super, super effective, especially when I have Cloud Shift for Cloud Blazer coming. Also, my opponent may not want to trade. Oh, they will now. No? Okay. Go ahead. How big of a problem is this Frenzy Goblin? Fairly major issue. I can kind of get my opponent here. Like, I can let them go to attacks and let them target the Man of War and then just blink the Man of War, bounce the Thresher Lizard, and eat the Frenzied Goblin. I think they're probably going to have Chandra's Outrage here, but I'm just going to counter it if they do. So let's go for that. Not the highest value because we have Cloud Blazer, but the fact that I get to eat Frenzy Goblin is a big deal. Looks like they didn't have the removal spell, which makes this all the better. New improved Man of War can block. So I'm just going to eat the goblin. That actually takes a really annoying problem off of the board. Oh, opponent does have something. No, nothing. Just going to recast the lizard. Yeah, I'm going to counter it. That lizard is going to be a 4-4, and that actually is annoying. Man of War. Pretty nice, but I am just going to be casting my Cloud Blazer here. Oh, don't let me untap. It's pretty good. All right, Lightning Bolt. Felt like they might have had that last time. Also smart to not let me untap there. What else you got? Get back Frenzy Goblin? Okay. Well, let's just start making about as many mana wars as you could possibly imagine here. Send this guy back. And we're just going to kind of go all in here. Because now we can really punish our opponent for having such an aggressive deck. Because cards like... Frenzy Goblin and stuff looks so much worse facing down big boomers like this. I don't even know how this is exactly going to work out, but I'm going to get them. I know that. All right. That works too. This guy. Pass. I think they're trying to set up a trumpet blast type scenario. Which is pretty reasonable, but also not going to work this time. Definitely just going to block a goblin. If they trumpet blast, it's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm at 15. I can just take that hit. And I can also just cloud shift any of these things to bounce the goblin and take less damage. May need to cloud shift the ranger if it actually gets hit with a removal spell or whatever, because I do want to keep it. As it's a nice copy target for the morph here as well. No, opponent decided not to attack at all. Fair enough. I'm just going to start clocking in the air then. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that what we're seeing here is them trying to set up the... They're trying to set up a, what's it called? A big trumpet blast. Wow, that's a nice one. Let's just cast it. Yeah, and that's why. I'm just going to copy this guy. 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I can force a block here. Yeah, I'm going to do that. They can't block with the Jackal Pups on both of the Man of Wars because then they're just dead. Yeah, they're trying. They're still just desperately trying to set up this this trumpet blast scenario. But I think that I can get them because I can just blink a mana war, which takes out yet another creature and gives me a blocker in the same instance. And I can also just conservatively block because now I have multiple lethal threats. It's exactly lethal damage if they have Trumpet Blast, and I don't block at all. 4, 8, 11, plus another 6, 17. Yeah, I know you have Trumpet Blast. Doesn't matter. You need, like, Lightning Bolt number 2 plus Trumpet Blast. All right. So 2020 deck is cruising right along. And I'll remind you that if you want to sell your cards, ChannelFireball.com is the place to go sell them. Really easy to do. And boy, I'll tell you what, if you want to get store credit, you'll get 30% bonus on that, which is fantastic. And I highly recommend it to get rid of those rares that you don't really need anymore. We'll see you in the finals. Finals time, and we did have a mulligan here, unfortunately. All right, this is a keeper. Sure. That could be useful, I suppose. Just because the way our deck loses is if we get ran over, right? We're not, nobody's drawing more cards than us in the late game. So we just need to make sure we get to the late game, and casting a bunch of mana wards is a fine way to do that. And speaking of, let's do that right now. Looks like we're going to get excluded here. Or just regular counterspell, that's fine. In fact, I'm actually kind of relieved to see that, because we're only getting hit for two a turn by this guide. Let's just run out another one. Send this guy packing. Pass. A morph has appeared. Will he lock it on anybody? Just gonna unsummon it. This is gonna give us a lot of information about how we can block, and also just buy us a ton of time to make sure that our sift is good. Zoetic Cavern. Fair enough. I'm just going to go for the Cloudblazer. They're representing potentially another counterspell, but we have Sift as a good backup plan in case they actually have it. Okay. They actually have it. Attack you for two. So I would have preferred Cloudblazer, but also didn't really think that they had the counterspell necessarily, so I'm fine with that. Shoreline Rangeaw. Okay, that's a good one for later. So let's sift for now. Wow, that's some good action. That is a lot of action. Wow. So Fiend Hunter, we can do some really cool stuff with. We can cast Fiend Hunter, put the ability on the stack, then cast Cloud Shift. Then Fiend Hunter leaves play. Ability goes on the stack that says return the creature to the owner's hand. Fiend Hunter comes back into play. Says take a creature back from their hand. So we have three things on the stack. First one resolves. We take a creature, put it underneath Fiend Hunter. Then another one says return the original creature with Fiend Hunter. That resolves, but there's no target. And then third, we get to just exile a creature straight up. So pretty good. Okay. Ghost Ship. Well, here I'm just going to actually take the time to go for the Cloudblazer, though. I don't love leaving the shields down, but I feel like while my opponent has the shields down, this is a really good time to try to pull ahead on cards and life and all that kind of stuff. So I think I'm just going to block the Shoreline Ranger and just blink, just Cloud Shift it right away. And that's just going to give us like a full grip of cards. And it's somewhat difficult to interact with. See if this works. Trying to soak up three damage, I think, is worth the risk. All right. Now we're all set up. So as long as they don't cast anything ridiculous here, actually, even if they do, we can just do Fiend Hunter to just kill it. But I would like to find one more, or our last Cloud Shift at some point here. Krogan Tusker. Hey, there's that Cloud Shift. Okay, so what do we want to do? Well, I wouldn't mind my own Krogan Tusker, so I could shapeshifter into that. But I think what we should do is just get rid of these two flyers. So let's do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold down Control. I'm going to cast Fiend Hunter. I'm going to hit OK. I'm going to target this. I'm going to tap, cast Cloud Shift. Okay. And then I'm going to eat the other one. All right, so do I want to use Fiend Hunter's ability? Yes. This one says, when this leaves the battlefield, return something. Now I just get to exile a creature. So that one's not coming back. If this guy dies, then yes, it will be gone. But they're not getting the other thing back, so that's gas. And then I'm going to peck in here. And we are going to take a hit from the Crows and Tusker. I don't think I'm going to chump block because I have answers for it. Like, I wouldn't mind just Vesuvian shapeshiftering it and then Path of Piecing it, but I don't see a big... Like, I think that leaving up Counterspell from this point on makes a lot of sense, you know, for cards like this, for example. Yeah, I'm just going to counter this. That's the kind of card that can be annoying long-term. Like, we're going to take a hit from the Tusker here for 5, unblockable, pay 5, unblockable, and then we take a hit, and that's annoying. But now I can just untap and Path of Piecing and Vesuvian Shapeshifter later. Accumulated Knowledge, what is that, draw a card? Yeah. What if I just want to Vesuvian Shapeshifter a Cloud Blazer? It's probably a little greedy. I'm just going to kill the... I'm just going to Path of Piecing this thing. Send it back in. Jam. And I think I just say go here because I want the Enter the Battlefield ability from Vesuvian Shapeshifter on either a Fiend Hunter or a Cloud Blazer, depending on what my opponent does. I'm just going to make a Cloud Blazer since my opponent didn't do anything. If there's any sweepers that I need to worry about at this point. And now I have lethal. All right. Turn the corner hard. So we're playing blue-green. This is where I want murder, to be honest. Let's see, they played a 6-5, so and some unblockable stuff. So even cards like Dragon's Eye Savants aren't super great just because like their big thing can hit us anyway. I think I just want another Mystic of the Hidden Way over the Sif this time, but I like the two Path of Peace and the Swords of Plowshares, and then the big dumb green creatures we can just deal with Mana War blinking. I think that makes sense. All right, let's see if we can pick up a trophy here. I almost won a trophy with my first draft. I was black-red with a ton of good removal, and I made it to the finals, and then I punted horrendously. It was kind of a weird type of punt, one that I don't do that often anymore, which is that I just didn't actually understand how one of my cards worked. Like, I hadn't played with it before, and I can't remember, I think it was Kindle. I thought Kindle added more damage or whatever than it actually does. And then, so my math was off, and I was like, oh, wait, it's 1+. Okay, yeah, that's stupid. Why did I think that? But it ended up being that my opponent was at 1 rather than 0. So, Z beats. Okay, so I think what I want to do here, ideally my opponent plays something I just counter here, but... Like, worth countering, I should say. A morph, yeah, I'm just going to counter. I don't want to deal with it. And then I'm going to just start casting these because I can, if I get two of these things going, my opponent's not going to win this game. How can I be most mana efficient? I can't really, so I'm just going to mana war here. And then I'll probably just Cloud Blazer next turn. Oh man, 5/5 with Trample. This is interesting. Yeah, let's just Cloud Blazer. This is going to draw us into removal and all types of nonsense. And then next turn, I can go like play a 3-drop, like probably Mystic face down, flip up this Mystic. And then, no attacks. And then have a bunch of mana available for nonsense. Could also just get rid of both of these creatures right now. I am not hating that idea, actually. Get rid of you. Let's just do this. 5 you. And then pass. This way I can leave up either Cloud Shift or White Mainline. And I can just basically just start going off with value. Like, I'm going to take this hit if they attack. I don't care at all. Yeah, they're going to have to just stay back, it looks like. Accumulated knowledge. Sure. Pass. All right, let's just White Mane Lion for Mana War. All right, opponent scooped, and we got the trophy. Nice, that deck. I don't know if I ever want to draft this set again, to be honest. We kind of peaked a little early. Sure, my black-red deck I mentioned before was kind of sweet. It had a bunch of murders and stuff, but this is about as good as it's going to get, I think. Anyway, thanks for hanging out. That was a sweet one. If you liked the video, you can give it a thumbs up, and if you want to subscribe, you will be notified of when new videos come out here from CFB. You can hit the little bell button down there. Thanks so much for hanging out. If you want to find me on social media, Marshall_LR. And you can find everything related to the podcast, limited resources, over at lrcast.com. We'll see you next time.